Hi everyone, it's Gina K from Gina K Designs and your host of Stamp TV. And today on Stamp TV, I'm going to show you a fun little Valentine's Day card that you can make, but you can make it for any occasion you want. Let me show you the tools and products that you're going to need to make this project. First, I'm going to use this set, and this is called Friendship Hearts, and it came out of the A Big Hello Stamp TV card kit. Then I'm going to use some masking paper, and this is the Gina K Designs masking paper. I'm going to be using that along with some white, black, and bubblegum pink cardstock. And then for ink, I'm going to use some black ink, some bubblegum pink, and some red velvet. I also have a Versamark pad, and I have some white embossing powder and some blending brushes. So the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to use this masking paper and I want to cut out a heart. Now I do have some heart dies that I've had in my collection for a while, but not everybody has heart dies. So I'm going to show you a way that you can do this with just a pair of scissors. And all I'm going to do is I'm going to fold this piece of masking paper in half. And I just want to make sure that it's even on both sides. And then I'm going to use the scissors to cut a very basic heart shape. Now, of course, if you have dies, it is a little bit easier, but it is not necessary. So I'm going to start by just kind of cutting this heart out. A nice kind of curve there and the V. So there's my heart, not too bad, right? Not too far off from this heart die that I have. And this is the piece that I'm actually going to use for my card project. So I'm going to take this piece of masking paper and I'm going to place it on top of a piece of white cardstock. This cardstock measures 3 3/4 inches by 3 3/4 inches, and I've cut my masking paper out to be about the same. So I'm going to line that up along the bottom. And then once I get that in place, I'm just gonna let it kind of fall into place and work my way up by pressing that masking paper down. All right, so I know that's a little difficult to see on the screen, but you can kind of see that the masking paper is just a little bit darker white. All right, now I'm going to use my embossing magic pad and I'm going to sprinkle that or rub that all over that heart because I'm going to do some embossing. I'm going to use a Versamark pad and then I'm going to use a small acrylic block and this heart right here from the Friendship Hearts stamp set. So I'm going to place that onto my acrylic block. Now the thing that's really nice about masking paper and why I prefer to do this kind of thing with masking paper as opposed to a piece of cardstock, it's very, very thin. So when you're stamping outside of it, it's going to stamp right along that line. It's not going to not make contact with the paper because the outside paper is so much thicker than the inside paper. It's so thin that it's going to look just perfect. Now I have some white embossing powder here and this is in one of these Glad containers. I like to use it this way. I have several jars of powder in here, but I use it all the time, so I like having it. All right, so I'm going to start with, let me just do that one more time here, to make sure I got everything off. Now I'm going to use the Versamark ink and I'm going to stamp one heart up here and I'm going to turn the hearts as I go. And you can see I'm just stamping right across kind of the top of this heart. Now it's very hard for me to see this. So what I'm going to do is after I get a row of hearts, I'm going to put the embossing powder on there. And now, I don't know that you can see this real well, but I can see exactly where those hearts are because I can see the raised embossing powder. So I'm going to continue to stamp hearts on here. Do a couple more. over this way. I like to turn the hearts in all different directions. And then once again, I did another row, so I'm going to sprinkle embossing powder on it so I can see it. All right, and I'm gonna continue. I know it doesn't look like much now, but I promise you're gonna like the way this looks. And you can do this with any kind of stamp. You could do this with flower stamps. You can do this with any little element type stamps. And it's just a really fun way to stamp inside of a shape. And I really like the shape in the shape. So using the same shape on the outside, which is the heart, and then stamping the hearts inside the heart. All right. Hearts are great any time of the year. It doesn't have to be for Valentine's Day. And that's why I kind of love having heart stamp sets in my collection. All right, and then I'm gonna do the embossing powder one more time here so I can really see where I'm going, and I have room for maybe one more heart down here. Let's put it right down there. And then I'll put the rest of the embossing powder on. Now at this point, if there's any embossing powder where you don't want it to be, I've got just a little bit right there. You can get rid of that with either a little paintbrush or just by brushing it off with your finger. You know what? I think I'm going to put one more right here as I look at it. I think it will look good. So I'm just going to put a little piece of a heart right there. Okay, and the last little bit of embossing powder. Okay, so now I'm going to emboss that using my heat tool. I'm going to let it heat up for just a minute, just to make sure it's nice and hot. Now, when you're doing this technique, you do want to make sure that you, I do see a little bit of something here, and normally, now that I'm doing these more lifestyle videos, you get to see my struggles. So I'm going to use this scissor and just brush that away. Okay. So when you're embossing, you do want to make sure that you emboss all of the embossing powder even outside of the masking paper, because you're going to do some ink blending on this and you don't want the embossing powder to get all over your ink blending. So you want it to all be embossed. This is going pretty quickly. And then if your cardstock curls too much, you can always heat it a little bit from the other side, and that will eliminate some of that curling. All right, that's looking pretty good. Okay. So now I'm going to use a little bit of ink blending, and I'm going to start with some of the bubblegum pink right in the center. Now, I have these two blending brushes here. I actually got these from Simon Says Stamp, and I just needed a bunch of ink blending brushes. So I still love my Picket Fence Studios ones, but these are also really fun from Simon Says Stamp. I just thought they were cute and colorful. So I'm going to ink up this brush with some bubblegum pink, and then I'm going to start in the center, adding some pink to these hearts. Now you can start to see them coming up. I'll do a little bit more over here. So I really want most of this heart to be pink, but then I'm going to add just a little bit of the red velvet around the outside. So here's some red velvet, and I have another one of the Simon Says Stamp blending brushes. I'm just going to brush a little bit of this off on a paper towel because I really don't want this to be very bright at all. Just want to add a little bit of red in there. And you can see I'm just blending that red into the pink. And I can always go back and blend out some of that red with more pink, which I'm going to do. Add more pink in there. Okay. So now that I have that done, I'm going to take my paper towel and I'm going to rub all over the surface of this just to get any excess ink off of the embossing powder. And now I'm going to peel off this masking paper. So let me get my nail under there and I will pull that off. Oh, this is so cute. Now, if you're more careful, you can reuse the masking paper, but the masking paper comes in a pretty big pack, so you can make a bunch of these little masks. So isn't that cute? So there's my little heart. Now, for my next step, I'm going to assemble part of this card. I'm going to tape this down onto this black panel. And because my cardstock did get a little curled from the heat embossing, I am going to use a little more tape than I normally use. But I think that'll be nice just to hold everything down. And the tape runner that I'm using is the Gina K Designs tape runner. It's the one that ThermoWeb designed for me. And then if you get any fingerprints anywhere, you can always just take your Mono Sand eraser and just sand those right off. This is a great little tool. I love it. Okay, now this whole panel is going to go on top of this bubblegum pink card base. For my next step, I'm going to add a greeting. So I found a piece of white scrap paper here, and I'm going to do the best friends forever because I don't necessarily need to make a million Valentines. I only have one Valentine, and that's my husband. But I have lots of friends that I would love to send a Valentine to. So I'm going to use this best friends forever stamp. And when it comes to, this is just a little tip, when it comes to these skinny long greetings, sometimes if you try to put them on the block, you can put them on so that they're crooked. They're kind of movable, which is really cool actually, because if you wanted to curve it around something, you certainly could. But if you want it to go on nice and straight, just turn it upside down where you want it, or just upside down, and then pick it up with your acrylic block, and that keeps the greeting nice and straight. So I'm going to use some black onyx ink for this greeting, and I'm going to stamp that just somewhere right on the white space. So this is the best friends forever. Now I took one of the dies out of Lisa Hetrick's new stamp set, her coordinating die set for her new You Anchor Me stamp set, and it happens to fit really nicely with this greeting. So I'm gonna just cut this out using this little flag die from the You Anchor Me die set. And if you feel more comfortable, you can certainly tape it down with some purple tape. But if you think you can manage it, like I'm gonna try to do here, I'm gonna cut it out without any help. All right. So there we go. That's looking pretty cute. There's a little tag. So to apply this, I am going to use some of the foam tape. And this is the Gina K Designs foam tape. And one thing I love about this tape is the width. It is very thin width for foam tape. Most foam tape is a little bit wider. This is the perfect size for these skinny little flags, and I really like that. So I'm going to place that foam tape on the back of this little flag tag. And then I'm just going to peel that off on the back. And I'm going to position it right over my heart. And let's see here. I want to make sure that I have it right in the center. That looks pretty good. So there is the greeting for this. And I like how it's popped up. It gives it that dimension. So let me show you a finished card that I did like this, and I added a few sequins. So you can see I added three sequins here and two up there, and the sequins that I added were disco ball. So you can see each one is a little different because I hand cut the hearts. So some of them are a little fatter, some of them are a little skinnier, but you get the idea. So there's this finished card project, and I want to show you a couple other designs that I did using this same little stamp set. Again, this is the Friendship Hearts that comes in a Big Hello card kit. So I did this one with some purples and some sea glass. I used lovely lavender and sea glass for this one. And for the design inside, I used the cute little stitched heart there. So I just stamped that all in there and embossed it with white and then used the lovely lavender and sea glass. And then for these, this is the sparkling sea sequins. So you can see they have that little bit of turquoise, but it also has a little bit of a pink in it too, which I love how that all goes together. So that's my second card that I made. And then I made one more. And for this one, I used one of the greetings from the A Big Hello stamp set from the kit. That's this one here. That's this big giant stamp set. So I used the I've Been Thinking About You. And for the little hearts inside, I actually used this little design. And I just randomly stamped it all around. And then I used some key lime ink along with some sea glass ink. And then again, I added some of the sparkling sea sequins in there to kind of accent that card. So here are my three finished card projects using that masking technique. Well, I hope you've enjoyed today's Stamp TV video, and I hope you'll give this technique a try. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button and the notification bell so you never miss another video. Here are a couple other videos I think you might enjoy, and thank you so much for joining me. I'll see you again soon.